Hi. I'm looking for a John Sidney Woods.
You're speaking with him.
Well, for years we've been studying actors' expertise, the nature of cognitive processes that professional actors use, and we've done many different types of studies, including for enhancing healthy cognitive aging with very elderly people.
Currently, there are a lot of researchers that have shown that mentally stimulating and maybe novel, unfamiliar activities benefit older adults in terms of their cognitive functioning. But so far, it's really been difficult to tease out what exactly are those activities that would be most beneficial.
My dad, first try, first time, 30 years later, I didn't even hear what he said next. My name is Michael Fosberg, and I'm your son.
We have a lot of behavioral evidence based on testing them before and after that acting does improve cognitive functioning when people are even given brief courses in acting. We're not talking about professional actors. Even brief coursing in acting seems to help. We took one group of students and told them to learn some material the most efficient way they could, and then we took another group of students and gave them 5 minutes of instruction in acting technique and say, don't try to learn this. Nothing to do with learning. Just mean what you're saying as you're saying it. And we found that the people who used an actor's way of approaching text learned more than students who were deliberately memorizing the same material.
And my body just sank. I braced myself with my left hand while I continued to hold the phone with my right. I felt very warm.
I don't actually think I have a good memory, to be honest with you. I mean, I can't remember like a lot of other things. Like, I'm a list person. I have to make lists to remember what I have to do. But I can go up on stage. I do a one-man show for an hour and 20 minutes on stage, constantly talking. I have no problem remembering that.
Descendants of the Woods and Robinson's family from Jefferson City in Columbia, Missouri, and have been living for the past 40 years in Virginia Beach, Virginia.
There is actually evidence that the acting process makes the brain more active, and that is what causes older adults to show improvement when they have been through an acting course or a course in theater.
Acting involves not just one area. So many things, cognitive interventions are really just thinking. But necessarily, acting involves thinking, feeling, and doing. Physiology is very much involved in gesture and movement, in body language.
Each one of these components would be activating a different part of the brain. So it would be your language areas, then it would be your motor area, and it would be your emotional area. And so there would be three totally different areas that should show stimulation.
So we'd love to identify those areas in the brain that seem to be mediating that effect. There's an old adage that stage time is always now. That's the point. You have to do it in the moment, instantly, and you have to engage all these brain areas simultaneously, and it's an active processing, what one psychologist calls mindfulness. It's being fully present in the moment, and it seems to be a tremendously healthy thing. So what we're trying to do is to design interventions for both students and elderly, and all the way along with the life cycle to get to that.